Where winning isn't just about being quick. Sometimes it's about stopping other drivers. Although sometimes, of course, they'll stop you. This is the story of the wild bunch of banger racing. We're way out west of Corfmullen in Dorset. These are the Weldon brothers. Scott Weldon, 36, the eldest. Gary, the mechanical brains. And Mark Weldon, three brothers, the founders of the team they call the Warlords. The Weldon boys were brought up in a knacker's yard. Mark is the slaughterman in the family business. But this isn't a knacker's yard just for animals. Cars come here too. Mind you, they don't bury them straight away. The Weldon boys can breathe life into old relics in a way ordinary folk wouldn't dream of. All in the name of banger racing.
Oh, you could build one in a day if you just want to strip it straight out. If you've got like 2 days, it'd take you the full 2 days. If you've got like a month, it'd take you a month to build them.
The beaten-up Jaguar is a hand-me-down from Scott to Mark.
Well, yeah, she'll go again, but I don't know if she'll go quite as good as she done the first time, but she'll do a couple of free laps, I expect. And hopefully stop someone in the process. No, banger racing ain't just all about winning, it's just going out for a good smash. A
bit of fun, take the aggression out on the cars. Sometimes you're a different person once you get behind the wheel. So.
Weldon by name, Weldon by nature. They put in an awful lot of work. It'll pay off on race day. They like to drive classic cars, Jaguars, Rovers and the like. More stylish, sort of. But they don't get many bouquets from classic car owners.
We like the classic cars, mainly because it's how banger racing used to be a few years ago. I mean, they're hard, they're strong, and there's nothing better than seeing an old classic go well out there, really. Which will upset the classic people.
Between them, the Weldons have won a bootful of trophies. But to operate as a team, you need other kinds of drivers too. Road blockers and jackmen. The sort of drivers who are happy just to sit there and take the hits with no fear.
No, I'm not frightened to death at all. It's the adrenaline's going and that's when I really enjoy it. I don't know why, but some people just bail out as soon as their car stops. But I'll sit in it and I'll take the hits. I love it. That's when I really do get going.
Oh, I'm just going to go out there and jack them up. That's it, basically. If they're in the way, got to get rid of them.
Them are the Warlords' big rivals, the crazy gang from across the Hampshire border, the baddies from North Baddersley Way. Them are Team Mental. These three are the core of Team Mental, hardcore. Andy Trippick, but call him Trippy unless you want trouble. Jason King, always trouble, on the track that is. And the leader of the pack, Mark Simmons, 28. He's tough, he likes to win. From a yard just north of Romsey, Mark runs a paint spraying operation. In the workshop next door is another racing driver who tried bangers just once.
You have got to have more than one screw loose to get out there and do banger racing. You have got to be totally and utterly shot, brain shot.
It's mental. It's exactly what they are.
The spares and repairs column in the classified ads, Mark needs a new motor.
14 and with service history, you wouldn't believe it, would you?
A new old motor, asking price £50, a deal at 25. Don't bother about a receipt.
25.
Thank you very much.
Lovely job.
It's amazing how many parts of a car are just a waste of space. Windows, lights, bumpers, most of the seats, door panels, dashboard, radiator, all of it gets stripped out. All in preparation for a little shindig with the Warlords at the Ringwood Raceway.
Every driver is different. Some drivers like going out and winning and getting trophies and doing like that. I'd just rather go out and have a good crash. If I have a good crash, that's as good as winning, really.
Derek Holland has dropped by. Derek is a bit of a banger racing legend. He knows that what happens on the night between Team Mental and the Warlords could affect everyone else who's racing with them, himself included.
I think the Warlords and Mentals are going to have their own little squash everybody else, get them out of the way, and then they'll have their own little war at the end, which I think would be quite good. I think most, like me, Mike Webber, and a few other top drivers, I think we'll just get disposed of in the first race. No problem.
Disposed of?
Yeah, they'll just move us out of the way and then they'll get on with their own little war. Mentals race more. They do more meetings in a year, so the crowd go against them a little bit because they're out crashing and upsetting everybody. The Warlords go out there, they don't squash so many people as much as the Mentals. The Mentals are, they're all mental, basically. It's just what they are.
Crash hard. You got to crash hard. They're in Jags, Arlott's in Granadas. You got to hit a Jag hard, and you got to hit it in the right place.
But before they can race their bangers, first, it's always a race against the clock to get the cars ready. The pressure is on.
Well, I'm stressed right out of my head at the moment.
It's very tense.
And what's that going to make him drive like?
A lunatic with any luck.
A lunatic? What else? Race night at the Ringwood Raceway.
Warlords are out in force as usual.
And swelling their ranks, Simon Byrne, Warlord number 6. And then there were 7, Nigel Baker, fast and sharp. For Team Mental, Glenn White is ready. Sean Dyer is dying to get at him. And crazy Reuben Simmons. The Laughing Cavalier. There are 3 heats on the night. The drivers race in all 3, if they survive that long. Strictly speaking, it's not a team event. Some drivers are dicing for the individual points championship. But of the 40 on the grid, 7 represent the white colours of the Warlords, and 7 the grey of Team Mental. Number 98, Trippy, will talk us through the start. The flag is green, and the Banger boys are off doing what they love best.
And they're off. And we're going. We're going crashing.
Through the first bend and into the straight, the engine's screaming. The Warlord Scott Weldon takes out his first man, Scott number 517. And this is Mark Simmons for Team Mental, making his first contact. Gary Pratt, one of his victims, his own team there, one of the Warlords, has been spun ahead of him. Simmons wearing a helmet and strapped in by the mandatory 4-point seat harness. That'll come in handy. He's on the tail of Gary Weldon. 2 Warlords in Granadas tonight. They can't always get their hands on a classic. Scott Weldon going well round the outside of 216, Nigel Baker. Mark Simmons. And just behind him, Trippy's view.
Somebody's been spun in front. Have a look. Bit of a pile-up. Straight into the Rover, just beat the steps out of that Rover.
The Rover of Gary Weldon, that is. Jason King, 356, comes through the smoke. He hits Weldon too. Scott on the chase after number 332, Chris Reed, who's back after a little dust-up with course officials that brought him a 5-year ban. Scott slowed down by cars strewn across the track. Over the years, he's broken half the bones in his body and several of other people's. Ahead of him, Nigel Baker, 216, near the front of the field. Chris Reed crashes, Weldon still trying to get past the estate car. And finally, he'll turn his man like so.
Ignition off. I'm getting out.
Trip is had enough. Nigel Baker, followed by Team Mental's Glenn White. Number 77 is Derek Holland, in trouble. Baker once again, nice style, taps the battered Volvo. But Glenn White is still right there on his tail. Now with Mark Simmons again, and sometimes you know it's just not your night. A series of huge hits. And it's not finished yet. The last one from his teammate Sean Dyer, the ultimate indignity. Meanwhile, the battle continues between Baker, the Warlord, and Mental Man White. Nip and tuck. Scott Weldon driving brilliantly. And John Searle will feel the force, does a little twirl. But was it wise for Mark Weldon, number 518, to try to race that old Jaguar again? Look at that steering. Certainly went past the MOT. Baker still showing his exhaust to White. White can smell him, but he can't quite touch him. Down amongst the roadblockers, Jason King, number 356, and Steve West ends up in the path of fellow Warlord Gary Weldon. The mayhem has begun. Mark Simmons on the left in the thick of it. Simmons tried to butt his way out, the wrong way. You are allowed to drive in the opposite direction on the two bends. It gives you something to do when your car is half crippled. The traffic jam is worse than the M25. All the Weldons are involved, but Scott, bulldozing through it all. Gary, on the other hand, way off the pace, is searching for Team Mental and Mark Simmons. Mission accomplished. Gary decides on a different way of getting around the track. Backwards. Basher West on the retreat too, against David Ball. He's one to look out for. These two like a pair of tussling buffalo. Scott Weldon fights his way through to complete another lap, number 517. And now he has a clear track ahead of him. Why? Because just about everybody else is stuck in a heap. Mark Weldon there, number 518. There's the smoke. Behind it, a pile of cars. Just have to sit and join the queue. On the other side of the pileup, Steve West in his element. And where there's West, there's King, the two kings of crashing. Again, West pumps up the power of the Rover. And now, how's this for the classic pincer movement? Two Weldons on one Mental. Gary Weldon, number 516, takes off while Mark comes in for another hit on Glenn White. If only he could steer straight. Scott has turned around to say hello to Sean Dyer. Not so much a race, more a demolition derby. And it's all brought to a halt without a single finisher. Or perhaps Jason hasn't quite finished.
Evening, gents. I think it's turned into a bit of a DD. First race is always likely that when they get this many cars out, it's likely that first race might turn into a derby. You just get a blockage and just everyone wants to go mad. And there's a lot of grudges tonight.
The question is, how many cars will be knocked back into shape for the second race? Time to head for the pits. As the smoke clears at the Ringwood Raceway, it's all frantic action in the pits, trying to put the bangers together again after the blitz of race number one. The cars of both Team Mental and the Warlords took a real hammering on the track, and here they go again. The Weldon boys are smiling though.
Got a bit squashed out there, the back's gone on it. I've done a dry shaft.
Can you get it back together?
Yeah, it'll go again for the next race, yeah. I'll pull it out straight. And...
one car stuck out the back of that Rover Underwood, so I come on, give him the big in. And come round and I think it was one of the mentals, Granada.
Well, I was in the pile-up, one of the Warlords came in, hit me.
Reversed off that, and I think our brother come in with a Rover and squashed him. So that was his lull.
The state of the car is the show for it, really.
Even so, Glenn White will race again, and Mark Weldon won't. Trippy, trying to get a spark. And Mark Simmons, never say die.
Sounds like I might have burnt the clutch out, I don't know yet.
That's something you can't fix.
Well, we can. We got one here, actually. Where's the man? He's not here. The man that bought one is not here. I think a few of our boys are dead, so... and I'm not sure what happened with Jaso. I don't know if Jaso's all right or not, so...
They're lifting, Chuck. Are they? Underneath all these wheels, every
time. Doesn't look too pretty, Jason.
Be all right. Be all right in a minute when we get it all pulled out.
You going to run it again?
Yeah, still going.
Mark was certain that this car was dead.
Nah, she's all right. Still goes, so get her out.
It's a miracle the whole of Team Mental will make it out once more. For the Warlords, Spike Kelly and Mark Weldon are non-runners, but Basher's all right.
Well, all the front wing's jamming into the front wheel. So if I beat it in a bit, away we go again.
After the truce, the war is about to resume, and this time, no prisoners. This is a world where road rage is all right, where madmen are almost admired. A world in which there are very few rules. No hitting on the driver's door, no more than 2 gallons of petrol, no engine modifications, no racing tires, no worries. Simmons makes his mark. Pratt, Prang. King, clobbered. Trippy feels the burn. Whose right of way was it? Derek Holland's championship blows up right here. Baker butchers Dyer. Getting out of the car is more dangerous than sitting tight. The walking wounded. Only 2 drivers will complete the course, while Team Mental and the Warlords count the cost. Jason King. Gary Weldon, contemplating his Rover sandwich.
Steering box is gone, so nothing you can do once that goes. Just go wherever the car wants to go.
It's also good night to Gary Pratt. Reuben Simmons isn't laughing anymore. And Trippy's day is definitely over.
Yeah, battery tray hit me in the shoulder. A little bit painful. Took some good hits and give some good hits.
Mark Simmons is towed out for more repairs and more stress. Gary Weldon will try to fix his brother Mark's Jaguar, but all in vain. So, Scott Weldon, the last of the brothers still running, and only just,
The actual wheel's gone in the bulkhead, so I'm trying to pull it clear, so I've got a bit of steering for the next race night, just to finish her off. Just to ruin someone else's day.
Managed to sort a few grey ones out as they was parked across the track in all sorts of ways, really. Yeah, it was a good bit of fun, really.
Four Warlords are still moving, and four from Team Mental, including Sean Dyer, who's almost unscathed.
Oh, I've been very lucky.
I'm going to see if I can nail a few more in the derby.
Scott Weldon making his way out onto the track one final time. And this is Mark Simmons, his Ford Granada fast becoming a three-wheeler, but at least he's on the grid. So we're on board with Sean Dyer for the final race.
They're all suddenly going, eh? No flags, nothing. Here we go, on going, well, there we go, up straight. Go, Fortnite.
12 laps will decide the race winner, but then they just carry on until just one is left running in the demolition derby. First casualty from the two teams is Glenn White, number 93. He'll try to stop a few others around the bend.
Take him in, hopefully. And again, right.
Next to go, Mark Simmons. Jason King auto-destructs. And here comes the dance of death. For the last Team Mental man running, Sean Dyer.
In the wall, sideways off.
The Warlords' Nigel Baker finishing it off for both of them. Steve West calls it a night. And here goes Scott Weldon. Sean Dyer jumped from his car as the last of the Warlords, number 172, Simon Byrne, piles in. Moments later, these two fatally lock antlers. Mark Simmons has broken the rules by jumping into another car, number 77, for one final hit. It'll earn him a six-week ban. And all that leaves Gary Reynolds, number 560 from Aldershot, as the winner of the demolition derby. The warring teams have wiped each other out completely.
Unpredictable banger racing. You never know just what's going to happen here.
One thing you do know, the banger boys will be back just as soon as they can get another car that moves. They just can't help it.
It's just unbelievable. It's just such a buzz.
I reckon.